Why post-process photos? Because taking them is only part of the job, especially if you're taking raw files. You've got to set a good exposure, create a good composition, and make sure your focus is good, because that's one thing you can't really change during post-processing. Post-processing is necessary to get the photo looking more realistic to the way your eyes see it, or to create something really artistic and really dynamic. So there's those two main possibilities there. Raw files are flat and dull. Without any post-processing, they lack color, vibrance, and contrast. You know, they contain hidden detail as well, stuff that you can't see with your eyes when you're just looking at them without processing them. If you've got a photo with a broad contrast range, a wide dynamic range, you might not be able to see details in the highlights and in the shadows as well. This can have a lot to do with how you've exposed your photo, and also the, like I said, the contrast range, the dynamic range in a photo. So to post-process will draw out detail that you might not be able to see with your eyes before you process them. You can also edit out imperfections like dust spots on your sensor and little things that you might not like to see, or things that you'd maybe hadn't seen a piece of trash on the ground that you wished you had bent over and picked up before you took the photo. Things like that can be edited out during post-processing. And the other side of post-processing is that you can enhance reality. You can do this a certain amount in camera. You can create photos with a shallow depth of field or a very slow shutter speed and capture motion blur. These are going to create photos that we can't see naturally with our eyes. But in post-processing, you can do anything you like, really, from removing an unwanted thing, an unwanted element in your picture, to merging and adjusting multiple photos and bringing them into one composition to create something completely fantastic and not real at all. So these are the main things that you've got to think about when you're considering post-processing. It is a learning curve, but it is an important learning curve, just as learning to use your camera is important. And you can do things two ways with post-processing, very much like you can do with your camera. With your camera, you can set it on an auto or a semi-auto mode and let the camera do the thinking, and it'll turn out fairly generic looking exposures. Or you can use it manually. You can set your exposures manually and get really creative with it. And this is the same with post-processing. You can manually alter every image you take and be as creative as you like with it, from either simply tweaking the way the color and the contrast looks to combining multiple images to create a piece of art. Or you can use presets. And there's tons of really good presets available. We've got a whole lot of them on photographycourse.net if you're interested. And these can help you really learn the potential for what you can do when you're post-processing your photos. So there it is. There's a couple of good reasons to consider post-processing your photos. I think for me, the most important one is to get my photos looking more realistic, looking more how I actually saw them. And then the other one is to create some art at times and do some other fantastical things that you can do, and the sky is the limit there. Thanks for watching. If you're new to our channel, please click that subscribe button. If you've learned something, click the thumbs up, give us a like, and we'll see you on the next video.